Det är jag tid för.
Hello Art Family, and thanks to all the new subscribers. For this video, I decided to do a rainy day sketch of this pizza shop in Westview, Pennsylvania. I'm trying out these Alvaro Castanet mop brushes, which I've come to really like. I'm working 16 by 20 on an Arches cold press block, which I've taped off a margin. And I'm using the squirrel mop. This is the largest size that he sells. It's a number 10. And it's very large. It may not look too large as the camera's kind of zoomed out, but it's a large brush and it holds a lot of water, and I've come to really like these mop brushes. As long as you control the amount of water in them, which is to say, you don't just use them fully charged every time you lay a wash down, you can get some really nice, large, even areas of color, which I've come to really like. I'm starting out by pre-wetting the whole sheet, and my main concern, of course, is the value. So I'm pre-wetting it to make sure I get an even kind of ghost wash across the whole thing, and I just want to set myself up with some brighter colors that will shine through in the end. While I have the sky nice and bright and yellow ochre, I want to put some lavender with a little burnt sienna in for some clouds that sort of take up most of the sky, with just a little bit of that bright sky peeking through. Then I'm going to move into more of a medium value, so using much less water on the brush. Using much less water means it will dry a little darker, a little closer to the way it looks when it's going down. And that initial wash you can see now is very light now because I had a lot of water in it. So having a lot of water in it makes it dry much, much lighter. So I'm setting in these tones and I'm using a lot of yellow ochre around the lit areas because I want to make sure that those are bright and luminescent and give the sense of light kind of bouncing around the scene. For the area behind the restaurant, there's a number of houses and other kind of cafes and shops and things. I'm not as concerned with those as I am the details on the objects that I want to be of interest in this sketch. So I'm kind of closing one eye and squinting at the reference photo, and I see that almost all of this is just a dark value. If you do that right now, you can kind of see that. So I don't want to focus too much attention to that area. I kind of want to allow that area to fall away. So I'm closing one eye and squinting and just going for those very broad general shapes of those objects. Now I'm starting to put in some darker value, especially around areas that have light. Now that I have darker areas, it helps to kind of anchor the sketch so that I can sort of judge things a little bit more clearly. As the darker values go in, it brings some clarity to the comparison, because value is a very kind of comparative, relative thing. So it's not until you have darker values anchoring the sketch that you can really get a full spectrum for the lights and the darks and where you want them to be. I'm also trying to be conscious of the reflection and how, despite the road being horizontal, there are some vertical strokes to the way I'm seeing these colors put in. I use white gouache straight from the tube to kind of put in the last accents and bring back that pink light. And now I'm just kind of noodling away at the detail, flipping it to get a better arc on some of those long power lines, placing in a couple figures, and that's going to be it for this sketch. I hope you got a lot out of it, and I'll see you in the next one. In the meantime, happy sketching.